Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will set up this vehicle that can drive and we can turn and the wheel is rotating. And this car is from city sample vehicle, and I try to explain how this project works. It is not complex as you might think. First, let's create a new project, launch Unreal Engine, choose games, blank project, and the project name is City Sample Vehicle, and click create. After we create this project, we select plugin and search for chaos vehicle plugin and enable this plugin to yes and restart. Go to Epic Game Launcher and scroll down to our city sample vehicle, or you can get it from the marketplace. It is free. Add to project and search for the project city sample vehicle and add to project. If you not yet have the city sample vehicle, you can go to this marketplace and search for city sample vehicle. And this can add it from here. Now we already add it and go to project setting, map and modes, and choose city sample vehicle map. Enable this missing plugin and choose this city sample vehicle. And after that, we have to restart. Map and mode, choose the city sample vehicle again. And click on map, open this city sample vehicle map. And you can play, but when we press W or S, it's not move because we don't have the enhanced input. So go to project setting, go to input, and this default player input class, choose enhanced player input, enhanced input component for Unreal Engine 5.1 or 5.2 or 5.3, we no need to do this because it use enhanced input default. Let's play, and now we can drive this car. And if we press number 4, we can switch to this car. We will set up this inside a new project. Let's create a new project. Go to File and New Project, Game and Blank. The project name is Vehicle Tutorial. A small tip, if you want to migrate anything from one project to another, you should use the same version of Unreal Engine. If we use 5.0.3, the other project should be 5.0.3. And then plug in, search for chaos vehicle plugin and restart it. Then in the content, create new folder, name it map, and the level name is city sample vehicle. Open this level, I've selected. Go to city sample vehicle project. And we copy all this lighting. And then paste it inside this blank level. Now we have the lighting. And go back again. Like all this floor, copy, Control C, and Control V. We have the floor. You can click on build and build light only to stop the red warning at this left side. Now we don't have any red warning. And we can save all. Go to project setting, map and mode. Like the city sample vehicle map as editor startup map. And city sample vehicle as the game default map. Because when we open this engine, this project, the engine will open this map automatically. And you can go to input. We not yet have the enhanced input. You need to go to plugin and search for enhanced input, and then restart. Go to input, select this enhanced player input, and we need some of the asset for us to start this setup. We need the vehicle 3 car. Press Control for select other folder, rig, physics, right click, migrate, and we disable this control rig. We don't want this. This blueprint, disable it, input. We not yet want the material, physics, we get it, rig, texture, disable, vehicle 2, we don't need it, vehicle 3, disable this VP vehicle 3 car, and we don't get this material. And the mesh, we get all this mesh, physics, texture, we don't need it yet. Vehicle 5, disable it. 8, disable the effect, and disable this with three importer. So click OK. If you can find the location of the project, you can search the project for vehicle tutorial, and this is the project, and then right click, click on show in folder, and this is the location, copy it and paste it inside this destination content folder. Enter, go to content, click on select folder. Now the content migration is complete. And you can see this is the asset that we need. In city sample vehicle, let's create a new folder. Name it blueprint. And right click blueprint class. All classes. Search for wheel. We call pound. And select. Name is VP vehicle. Can open this VP vehicle. And we have this vehicle movement component. This is the main engine of our vehicle. Let's set up the input. Right click new folder, input, and new folder, generic, and another one is vehicle. For the generic, let's go to input, input action, IA AC look, open it, and this look we set the value type to axis 2D. Then input, input action, IA, LC, look, delta, pan it, and exist 2D. And create input mapping context. Name is IMLC input mapping. Open it. And this mapping we add to IALC look, the input action. And then choose this key game path, search for game path thumbstick 2D axis, and add modifier like that zone. Add mapping, IALC look data, and close mouse advice to exist. And the array add array naked. Now for the vehicle input, I click input action IA VH break. And select the value type is exist 1D. Trigger is add the array. Choose release. Add array. And choose down. Add new input action. The name is IA VH handbrake. Open it. And this handbrake is value type is digital bool. Add new input action. The name is IAVH steering. Value type is axis 1D because we steer left and right. And add modifier, we have that zone. Add another input action. Name is IA VH throttle. And the value type is axis 1D because it moves forward and backward. And trigger when it's down, and another one when it release. Then add input mapping context. The name is IM VH input mapping. Open it. Add mapping. Choose IAVH handbrake. And the key, click on spacebar. Then add mapping. IAVH steering. And the key is A. Trigger when it's down. And release. Modifier is negative. For the negative. And we have modifier with that zone. And then add the key and click on D. When we move right, add mapping IA throttle. And click on W. and then add mapping IAVH break. Click on S, it is break. Let's save all of this. Go to the city sample vehicle project and open BP vehicle. And we can copy all of this. Static mesh and spring arm. Now let's pass it. We have this vehicle. Let's compile and go to city sample project and drag this blueprint BP vehicle inside the scene and click on it. Go to open level blueprint and when we right click we can see this reference, create a reference to BP vehicle. Make sure that you click on this vehicle to get this reference. And then add new function. Name it to process vehicle. And add input. The input is pound and the variable type is pound object reference. Then search for process function and this one pound. And connect this pound to in pound. Get player controller. Name it to target. The event graph. We call this process vehicle. And connect begin play and we process this BP vehicle. When we begin play, we possess this car, so we can drive this car. We call the wrong get player controller. Get choose this context sensitive and get player controller. This player index is 0. Compile. Now when we press play, we process this. Go to BP vehicle and the mesh. Skeleton mesh. We choose this SKM vehicle car vehicle 03. This is the skeleton mesh, but it don't have the mesh inside it. It only have the bone. And this the mesh we use this static mesh. And choose the anim class ABP vehicle. You can see it, this ABP vehicle. Open. And we have the wheel controller and control rig and then output. This wheel controller will control the wheel of the car when it's rotate. Now go to event graph and to use the enhanced input. We have to add the enhanced input to the mapping context first. So call event process and the controller has to layer controller get the enhance input local player subsystem and add variable. The variable name is input mapping. And variable type is input mapping context object reference. And duplicate it. Name it input look mapping. Compile. And this input mapping, we use this input we call IMVH input mapping. And this look, we use this LC input mapping. Then get input mapping, add mapping, contact, and connect this to mapping contact. And connect this to target and this input mapping to the mapping contact. Copy this app mapping contact and input look mapping. The mapping contact and this enhance input local player subsystem. We can combine this mapping into one, but we want to use it separately. If we don't want the input to control the look rotate of the vehicle, we just don't add this mapping. And create another event and process. When we unprocess, we stop controlling this vehicle. So cast to player controller and call enhance input local player subsystem and then call remove mapping contact. Get input mapping, connect it to mapping context. And remove another one. Is connect it to target. Input map look mapping. After we add the mapping context, we can create the action. Event IA LC look data and then break the action value call make rotator this X to Z and Y, multiply it with minus 1 pitch. Get spring arm. Spring arm is the arm that connects to the camera. We add local rotation and connect to data rotation. When it trigger, we add this local rotation. And the spring arm get relative rotation. Click track set relative rotation. Make rotator, make it to new rotation, and for the pitch, we clamp the angle. The angle is minus 50 and minus 10 because we don't want the player to look over the vehicle. You can adjust it by yourself if you don't like this value. And for the Z, clamp angle, min is minus 90 and max is 90. If you want to rotate 180 degrees, you no need to clamp this the yaw value. IAVH throttle enhance action event. Get vehicle movement component and set throttle input when it trigger and when it complete action value. And IA VH brake. Get vehicle movement component and set brake input trigger and complete and it to brake. Another is IA VH handbrake. Add vehicle component and set hand brake input. We trigger it when start ongoing and complete the action value to this hand brake. And another one is IAVA steering. For turning the vehicle, get vehicle movement component and set steering input trigger started ongoing complete and action value. For our vehicle, it's very easy because we have this vehicle movement component that is the default component from Unreal Engine. So we have every variable and the function that we can use and set up for our vehicle to move easily. Let's play test and now we can look around the vehicle because we have the clamp, the angle, so we can not look from the front. Now let's set up our vehicle movement component and the wheel setup. Add array and choose wheel class. We go to the vehicle directory and the physics. This is the wheel blueprint for the front and this is for the back rear to print. You can open and see the physics of this wheel and adjust this. For the front wheel, we use this front, and we have two front wheel and two rear wheel. You can open this skeleton of the vehicle and character bone, all hierarchy, and we have this four bone. So for the front wheel, it's wheel front turn L, and copy selected bone name and paste it inside the front left. And another one is front turn right, copy, and then wheel rear L, copy the bone name and copy this wheel rear R, this bone name. And to attach this static mesh of the wheel to the vehicle movement component system, we have to go to instruction script, create a new function. Name is attach nanite to skeletal mesh. Get SM wheel front L. Call attach component to component. And the parent is the mesh of this vehicle. Socket name, the name that we use, wheel front turn L. It is the wheel front bone. And keyword for the location, rotation, and scale rule. The same with wheel R. And static mesh, and connect it to the mesh as the parent and turn R. And SM wheel rear L, attach component to component, get mesh, socket name is wheel rear L, keeper. Copy this. SM wheel rear R and this mesh. And then SM brake pad L. You can see this brake pad when we click on it. We not yet assign it, so go to static, and this is the brake pad L. Go to the static and brake pad R. This is the brake pad. And copy this attached component. Because this brake pad is at the front wheel, so we attach it to the front wheel L, and brake pad R is attached to the front wheel R. We attach it because the vehicle moves only the bone when it rotates the bone, so we attach it to that bone. Go to vehicle movement component, and this wheel stress collision. For the vehicle, we block it. And engine startup. Can find the curve that we have migrated. This curve, use it for the external curve. Make cost 500. The max RPM is 5,400 and engine idle RPM 1,600. Engine brake effect is 0.1 and this one is 5 and 600. Differential setup, rear wheel drive and front rear 0.5. Then the transmission setup. Set this automatic reverse to fall. Forward gear ratio. Delete this. We only use 4. This one is 2.82. Index 1 is 1.5, index 2 is 1, and the one is 0.7. And this reverse gear ratio, delete this, index is 2.32. The gear change time is 0.2 and this transmission efficiency is 1 and the steering setup we chose Ackerman 0.8 angle ratio steering curve we can adjust it the same as this project. Right click and copy and paste it inside this. Reverse as brake and the mass is 1850 and enable center of mass override 26 0 and 86. And cost control. Set this rotation damping to 0. And when you adjust this variable, we have different behavior for the vehicle. For us to about to move this vehicle, we have to go to mesh. And then scroll down, simulate physics, and set the linear damping to 0. Let's compile and play test. Now we can move the vehicle. And we can turn. But the wheel is not turned and not rotate. We have to attach nanai to skeleton mesh inside the construction script. This construction script call before the begin play. This begin play. So we attach this wheel before the game is playing. Let's play test. Now move, and our vehicle is moving, but the physics is a little bit strange. So we attach this SM brake pad L to the wheel front L and this one to the wheel front R, because this bone is not rotate and the brake, this brake should not rotate with the wheel. We have the steering problem for the vehicle because we set the wrong center of mass. Search for center of mass in the vehicle movement component, and the Z value is 56, not 86. Let's play test. And now we don't have any steering problem. Let's migrate the material of this vehicle 3 and another material. Click migrate. We done migrate this control rig. The blueprint input. Rig texture come with this material. The mesh disable it, the physics, vehicle file disable, effect, prototype, Niagara, V3 importer. And this is what we have to migrate, the material and the texture. Go to content, and then select folder. Yes, all. Now we have this material. So go to the mesh, and we apply this material to the static mesh. You can use at this material that we should use. Go to MI folder. Quentin. Enable the missing setting. 13. Well, 15. Fourteen, 16, 18, 7, 19, 20, and 21. If you use your own hair 3D model, it doesn't have this complex material because this material is, they divide it by part of the hair. And we restart to apply the new setting that we just enable and save selected. Now our vehicle have the material. And this is the end of our tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please hit like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And if you want to create the advanced locomotion system, you can click on this video here. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the future tutorial.